Journalists are always seeking new and intriguing and inspiring stories. And so one of the best things that you can do as an author is to create a press release, which will allow you to be featured on well-known sites like ABC and Fox News and things like that. It's a great way to get in front of a new audience and to really highlight who you are as an expert author. Now, a lot of authors submit press releases, and so the idea of submitting a press release can be very overwhelming. So let's talk about what makes a high quality or good press release. First, you're gonna want an intriguing author story. What is really exciting or makes you stand out as an author? Then you'll want a captivating book title, like something that's really catchy and just grabs people's attention. Any awards that you have received, like a bestseller or Peace Prize or whatever, like you're gonna wanna be able to highlight that and showcase that in your press release. Also, if you have a special endorsement on your book from like a celebrity or something like that, that's also really captivating in a book press release. In any way that your book may tie in to modern trends, like is it something about millennials? Is it something about the keto diet? Is it whatever it is that ties into current and popular trends, you'll wanna highlight that. Those topics are going to be what makes for a captivating and intriguing book press release, which ultimately makes you stand out and get your press release accepted so that you can get in front of a new audience. Now, I know you're probably wondering, okay, let's say that I have some of these things or all of these things. How do I go about actually writing a book press release? Let's talk about that. So for a book press release, you're going to want a heading, right? And your heading needs to be probably under about 15 to 20 words, but you wanna make sure that it's intriguing or catchy, right? You want to make sure that it captivates and brings your audience in. Second thing is you may wanna consider a subheading. This is totally optional, but if your heading is really catchy and you want something that kind of gives it like a tagline or something that explains it a little bit more in depth, then you'll wanna consider moving into creating a subheading with your heading as well. Then you're gonna want an intro, something that again is catchy and bringing them in and immediately grabbing their attention. Think about it, when you typically write books, you write something that's pretty catchy and bringing them in as well, whether in the synopsis or in the first chapter. You wanna think about that with the press release because the intro is really their introduction to you and what you have to offer in this press release. Then the next thing you'll want to consider is an author quotation. Think about it, like people are going to want to share your quotes on social, or that'll be like the quote that you're somewhat known by. So you want to avoid like catchy or cliche phrases, but you want a really deep and intriguing and inspiring author quote that you can add into your press release as well. After the quotation, you're going to want to have an author bio. Now, here's the thing, you don't want it to be a page long. I typically say somewhere around 2 to 3 paragraphs, but make sure that every sentence that you include in the author bio counts. Like, think about it as you're writing it. What value is this adding? What are my people getting to know about me by this sentence specifically? So talk about who you are, talk about who you are as an author, talk about what you like to do, maybe any other titles or what got you into this, so any license or certifications in relation to that. But you want to make sure that it's valuable, not just kind of like run on where people just have to learn all about you for paragraphs and paragraphs and pages upon pages. Make it concise, but also make sure that it's valuable. After the author bio, you're going to want to share your book information. So what about your book is awesome? Maybe like 2 to 3 paragraphs that you can share about your book. This could be the synopsis, but just like well expanded a little bit. It could be the most important parts that you want people to know. It could be what you know stands out to your audience that you really want to highlight to a new audience. But you want to think about book information that you can present in this press release effectively. Then you move into contact information. So where can people find you? What can they look for you at on social media? Where's your website? Where's your email? That sort of thing. So that those that are interested in maybe taking it to the next step, maybe other places want to feature you, they know how to connect with you further. Finally, what I think is the most important part of the press release is a call to action. Do not skip this part, okay? We can tell readers all these great things about ourselves and highlight all these fantastic things about ourselves, but if we don't tell them what that information means for them or what to do with that information, it's useless. So when you think of a call to action, you're going to want to think of what you want your readers to do with that information next. Do you want them to sign up for a free consultation? Do you want them to opt into your newsletter or to your blog? Do you want them to share that information with other people? Do you want them to connect with you on social media? Think of a comprehensive way you can kind of sum it all up and give them a call to action. So for example, you can say, if you're looking to write your own book, please check out my website or sign up for this free strategy call or sign up for this freebie that will get you started on your aspiring author journey. Something like that so that they know what to do. I think that this is the biggest mistake people make when they create press releases is they forget to tell their audience what to do because people want to know what to do with the information that you give them. So do not skip the call to action. Then after you've created that template or that draft, you're going to want to have it professionally edited. I promise you that this is going to be a great step to showcase who you are as an author. You do not want it to be just somewhat edited because that's a representation of you. So have it professionally edited, and then you move into selling it to PR sites. So like PR.com or newswire.com, that sort of thing. Doing a press release is one of the greatest ways to get increased publicity. So I highly recommend this for all authors. So now you have the skills. Now you can get started. I'm going to let you dive in and get going. And until next time, I will chat with you guys later.